Οι υποδρομίες στην Αγγλία δεν περιορίζονται μόνο στα στοιχήματα και σε ό,τι έχει σχέση με τα τυχερά παιχνίδια, αλλά είναι ένας εθνικός θεσμός με μεγάλη κοινωνική διεύρυνση. Είναι ένα σπορ που το απολαμβάνει όλη η οικογένεια και παράλληλα οι υποδρομίες είναι μια τεράστια βιομηχανία η οποία συνεισφέρει δισεκατομμύρια λίρες στην αγγλική οικονομία. Στην Αγγλία, την Ουαλία και τη Σκωτία λειτουργούν σήμερα 62 υπόδρομοι. Όλοι ανήκουν σε ιδιώτες και ιδιωτικές επιχειρήσεις, εκτός από τον φημισμένο υπόδρομο του Άσκοτ, που είναι ιδιοκτησίας της Βασίλισσας Ελισάβετ, γνωστή για το πάθος της για τα άλογα και τις υποδρομίες. Η Βασίλισσα της Αγγλίας είναι ιδιοκτήτρια μεγάλου αριθμού αλόγων που παίρνουν μέρος στις υποδρομίες. Σύμφωνα με τα τελευταία στοιχεία της Βρετανικής Αρχής Υποδρομιών, οι προπονητές με επίσημη άδεια είναι 650, οι επαγγελματίες και οι ερασιτέχνες αναβάτες είναι συνολικά 790 και ο αριθμός των αλόγων που είναι στους στάβλους των προπονητών ξεπερνά τις 15.000.
So the British Horse Racing Authority is the governing and regulatory body for the sport. So first of all, we are responsible for setting and enforcing the rules of racing, but also for the overall running of the sport and the representation of the sport to external audiences such as government.
Are you a government body?
We're not. We are the government appointed body with the responsibility for the running and regulation of British racing. So we're actually separate from government, but we are appointed by government. So the economic impact of British racing is estimated to be about £3.5 billion. And much of that is in the rural economy, which obviously makes it quite unique as an industry. And we estimate that about £330 million worth of tax is generated by the sport each year. One of the great assets of British racing is that it's a wonderful sporting product. It's a wonderful sport to watch and people engage with, but also it's a brilliant social day out. So you get a lot of family-themed race days, and in British racing, kids under the age of 18 actually go free if accompanied by an adult. And also it's a great social event as well. You get a lot of people going to enjoy the day out and the spectacle of a day of a races with their friends, as well as enjoying the sporting action.
And are there any strict rules to avoid corruption in horse racing?
Upholding the sport's integrity is crucial, and the British Horse Racing Authority is responsible for this. We have an extremely sophisticated integrity systems. We have links with all the bookmakers, so we can monitor betting activity in real time, and any suspicious patterns can be flagged up, and we can act on that. We also have a wide web of investigating officers and intelligence out there in the field gathering information on suspicious activity.
And how severe is the punishment if somebody is found guilty of corruption?
It can be extremely severe. So our responsibilities extend only as far as regulating horse racing. So we can't impose, for example, penal sentences on individuals, but we can impose very heavy fine, very serious fines, and more commonly, very long disqualifications from the sport. We had a recent case where a jockey was disqualified from the sport for 15 years, and that disqualification means they can have no involvement in the sport of horse racing, either in Britain or worldwide.
Τα χιλιάδες γραφεία στοιχημάτων στη Βρετανία αποτελούν ένα θεσμικό κρίκο στη βιομηχανία των υποδρομιών και συνεισφέρουν σημαντικά ποσά στην αγγλική οικονομία.
The amount of money we give in corporation tax, etc., is over £1 billion. So they do extremely well out of the betting industry. We pay every single tax that you can possibly imagine, but we also pay a percentage of our profits like everybody else.
And how many betting shops are in England?
So there's over 8,000 betting shops in the UK. We own just over 2,300. Yeah. But the funny thing about the shops is that they have changed completely. So I've been in the industry for about 13 years. And when I first joined, you know, everything was about horse racing. That was 80-odd% of our turnover. It was 20% other sports and football. Now it's basically 50-50 in the shops between the machines we have upstairs and the racing and the football.
Ο Ιαν Βίλιαμς είναι ένας από τους γνωστούς προπονητές στον Βρετανικό υπόδρομο. Το συγκρότημά του, σε ένα χωριό μία ώρα έξω από την πόλη Μπέρμιγχαμ, καλύπτει μία έκταση 1000 στρέμματα, με σύγχρονους στάβλους, χώρους προπόνησης των αλόγων και διαμερίσματα για το προσωπικό του. απασχολεί 40 περίπου άτομα.
And the requirements to obtain a license for training.
When I first started training, they were quite hard, in that you needed good references from previous employers, you needed to be able to prove that you were financially viable and that you had stables and facilities that were good enough to be able to train horses to running races. All of which sounds quite easy, but the inspectors from the BHA are very difficult. They look at everything, and they want to ensure that the horse is going to be looked after in a correct and a professional manner. More recently, the regulations have become much tighter, and now, no matter how much experience you have, no matter how long you've been in the business, you have to pass modules of a course, and the course is many weeks, and it's a real tough course to pass, and on top of that, you have to show that your facilities are good enough to train horses, that your security is good enough, that your knowledge is good enough, that your financial resources are suitable enough to be able to train racehorses. So it's very difficult. It was much easier when I first took my license 20 years ago than it is now. And they literally, you have to jump through hoops now and prove that you can do the job, or prove that you can cope with all the elements of the job. As you're an employer, you're a business, you have to be able to prove your horse welfare abilities, you have to be able to prove your knowledge of racing in general, as in the program, as in the race courses. It's a tough job now to become a racehorse trainer. It's not easy.
Τι είναι όμως αυτό που έχει κάνει τις υποδρομίες θεσμό στην Αγγλία?
I think it's tradition. Yeah. I think when you look at meetings like Royal Ascot and the Queen arrives in her carriage and all the pomp and ceremony, the tradition of horse racing in England stands it in very good stead. And as a trainer, just as other jockeys were actually, we have the task of trying to keep racing that way. And I think it's important that we maintain racing's integrity, yeah. We maintain racing's public interest. The BHA are trying to work with the public, with public authorities, to try and keep people interested in a sport that is in our heritage and is part of our tradition.
Ρώτησα τον Ian Williams πώς θα μπορούσε, κατά τη γνώμη του, ο ελληνικός υπόδρομος να έχει μεγαλύτερη απήχηση στην ελληνική κοινωνία και παράλληλα να προσελκύει γνωστούς ξένους προπονητές και ιδιοκτήτες αλόγου.
It's very difficult, but for anything to be successful, you have to create interest. If a football team has more fans than another football team, it will have more finance, and ultimately it boils down to money. But if you create more interest, so if you can, at grassroots level, get people to the races, get them interested in going to the races. There was a wonderful thing. We had a runner in the Melbourne Cup 5 years ago, and a big thing that the Melbourne Cup had done in previous years was they'd invited the ladies to the races. So once the ladies were going racing, the gentlemen followed. So you have to get people to the races so that they can enjoy the spectacle of
become
it.
A family sport.
Become a family sport. When you go racing in Australia, Melbourne Cup Day, the whole city of Melbourne grinds to a halt. There's 120,000 people end up going to Melbourne for the races. There are old people, young people, children, families. Everybody's enjoying the spectacle of the day. Everybody likes to dress up. They enjoy that whole big occasion. But to do that, you have to start it from the bottom and get people interested in going racing.
What kind of incentives will you make you interested to take part in Greek horse racing?
I think subsidies with the travel. Obviously, it's a difficult place to travel to with a horse. It's not somewhere we can put a horse in a horse box and go. So, and that can be very expensive if you start having to use air travel and prize money. You know, you have to have a reason to persuade a client or an owner that actually, if we can go and race in Greece, we have this opportunity to win this race with this prize money, And actually, you can take your family and have 5 nice days there and enjoy the whole experience. But this is why we need to go, because there's a prize money offering or a subsidy which helps with the expenditure of going. Its incentives will encourage people to anywhere in the world. Yeah. Dubai, Sheikh Mohammed with his Godolphin operation and Emirates, they've created the most wonderful carnival now in, it's January, February, March, but they offer huge incentives to the trainers. If you have a horse good enough to be invited to Dubai, they will actually fly your horse to Dubai for you and fly it back on the condition that it runs within the carnival. And the prize money is tremendous. And we all love to spend some time in the sun during the winter as well. So it's a real great opportunity. But there's some really huge incentives to go. And it's an international stage.
Πρόσφατα, η Βρετανική Αρχή Υποδρομιών καθιέρωσε το πρόγραμμα στις υποδρομίες μαζί.
Racing Together is a project where the BHA are linking with other groups and other people, and they're taking racing into the community. So they're trying to involve older people within racing, they're trying to involve young people, but it's an opportunity for racing to put something back into the communities it touches.
Η Βρετανική Αρχή Υποδρομιών έχει επιβάλει αυστηρούς κανονισμούς για να προστατεύεται η καλή ποιότητα ζωής των αλόγων.
Yeah, there are very stringent rules set out by the BHA, our licensing authority. It revolves around medications we can use and medications we can't use before or during racing. And the horses are very well monitored by the vets at the BHA.
What is the cost of keeping a horse here?
The general cost of keeping a horse in training for 12 months is around £20,000 sterling, which covers most of the expenses that you would have. But nevertheless, there still can be some very expensive veterinary fees if a horse needs an operation on perhaps a colic or to put a pin in a fracture or repair a knee or an ankle should something go quite badly wrong.
How many horses do you have in your yard?
We have about 90 horses here in the yard. That can stretch up to 100 on occasions. Uh-huh. And we're predominantly, we're split between flat horses and jumping horses. So we have a lot of flat horses.
Do you have foreign owners?
We do have foreign owners. We have owners from America. Mm-hmm. We have owners from Dubai. And actually, we have owners from Greece.
Oh, yeah.
A good friend of mine, is a gentleman called Sartorius Hasiarkos,
yes.
Who is well known to many Greek people, I'm sure, particularly in the racing world.
Yeah.
And he enjoys his interest in horse racing with his great friend Sir Alex Ferguson, who has horses with us as well.
Oh.
So we're very lucky.
Ο Έλληνας Σωτήρης Χασιάκος, για τον οποίο μίλησε ο Ιαν Βίλιαμς, είναι διευθυντής σε μεγάλη επιχείρηση ψυχαγωγίας στο Λονδίνο και δραστηριοποιείται εδώ και πολλά χρόνια στον Αγγλικό Υπόδρομο. Ως ιδιοκτήτης αλόγων έχει κερδίσει σημαντικά έπαθλα. Στη φωτογραφία η Βασιλομήτωρα Ελισάβετ, η οποία έχει φύγει από τη ζωή, συγχαίρει τον Σωτήρη Χασιάκο για την επιτυχία που είχε άλογό του στις υποδρομίες του Άσκοτ. Ποια είναι τα ενδιαφέροντα που βρίσκεται στον Αγγλικό Υπόδρομο?
Ο Αγγλικός Υπόδρομος είναι King of Sports, το λένε στην Αγγλία.
Βασιλιάς των Sports.
Βασιλιάς των Sports. Φυσικά πριν ήταν για τους πλούσιους που είχαν χρήματα και ασχολούνταν με τα άλογα να τα πάνε στον υπόδρομο, αλλά σήμερα είναι για τον απλό άνθρωπο. Όταν πηγαίνεις στον υπόδρομο, πηγαίνεις για να διασκεδάσεις. Παίρνεις την οικογένειά σου, παίρνεις τους φίλους σου, οι εταιρείες παίρνουν τους πελάτες τους. Παραδείγματος χάρη, εγώ εδώ που εργάζομαι, έχω box στο Άσκοτ και παίρνω τους πελάτες μου για να τους ξεναγωγήσω, να τους διασκεδάσω. Πηγαίνουνε, διασκεδάζουν, μπορεί να παίξουν λίγο αν θέλουν, αν δεν θέλουν να παίξουν δεν παίζουν. Ναι. Αλλά πηγαίνουν για διασκέδαση. Είναι το excitement που παίρνουν από το horse racing.
Και ποια θα ήταν τα κίνητρα που θα μπορούσαν να σας κάνουν να ενδιαφερθείτε και για τον ελληνικό υπόδρομο?
Τα κίνητρα που θα χρειαστούν για την Ελλάδα είναι να προσπαθήσουν να βρουν ειδικές μέρες που να έχουν για τον ελληνικό υπόδρομο. Παραδείγματος χάρη να το κάνουν φεστιβάλ. Να έχεις το Πάσχα, έχεις τα Χριστούγεννα. Αυτή την εποχή να μπορείς να κάνεις μερικές υποδρομίες και να προσελκύσεις τον κόσμο να έρχονται. Παραδείγματος χάρη στο Χονγκ Κονγκ έχουν international racing το Νοέμβριο και το Δεκέμβριο. Στο Ντουμπάι έχουν Νοέμβριο-Δεκέμβριο και το Μάρτιο που είναι το
Ντουμπάι Cold Cup. Στο Ντουμπάι και στο Χονγκ Κονγκ.
Έχω πάει, ναι, πάρα πολλές. Πηγαίνω κάθε χρόνο. Ναι. Με προσκαλούν και πηγαίνω. Προσπαθούν να προσελκύσουν γιατί αυτό αναπτύξει τον τουρισμό για το, ναι, και για το Χονγκ Κονγκ και για το Ντουμπάι. Το Ντουμπάι πηγαίνουν περίπου κάθε χρόνο. Δεν μπορεί να βρει θέση να πας πάνω του Μάρτιο ή αν δεν το κλείσει. Γιατί όλοι θέλουν να πάνε αυτή την εποχή. Ναι. Γιατί είναι International Racing, Dubai Cup. Πληρώνουν 6 εκατομμύρια λίρες για το prize money.
Από ό,τι γνωρίζω, ήσασταν συνειδιοκτήτες αλόγων με τον γνωστό, τον πρώην manager της Manchester United, τον Alex Ferguson. Είχατε άλογα μαζί?
Ναι, πάρα πολλά. Πάρα πολλά και τώρα τελευταία τα
πούμε. Είχατε δώσει και αρχαία ελληνικά ονόματα, νομίζω. Ε?
Ναι, όλα τα ονόματα τα έδινα εγώ. Φυσικά έδωνα ελληνικά ονόματα. Διακτόρος, Ποσειδώνας, όλα Αϊτός, Παυσανίας. Ναι. Ναι, όλα ελληνικά ονόματα.
Εμπορικά πήγατε καλά?
Πήγαμε καλά γιατί το πρώτο το άλογο που πήραμε, το Αϊτό, είχε σπάσει το πόδι, τώρα ένα πολύ καλό άλογο. Το δεύτερο ήταν ο Ποσειδώνας, ναι, που κέρδισε το Free Handicap στο Newmarket και κέρδισε και στο Goodwood την πρώτη κούρσα όταν ήταν 2 χρονών και το πουλήσαμε φυσικά και δεν χάσαμε χρήματα.
Τώρα έχετε άλογα μαζί?
Τώρα προς το παρόν τα πουλήσαμε φέτος και προσπαθούμε να πάρουμε καινούρια τον επόμενο.